Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Tomasz Paszkowski, and I'm Cloud Solution Engineer from Intel. And today's lightning talk is about Ironic and how we can leverage that for bare metal workloads and what's the future with Intel RSD. So why Ironic is important? So in every modern data center, bare metal provisioning is an essential thing. So whenever you deliver new hardware to your data center or you deploy something new, you need to go to bare metal provisioning. And Ironic has this advantage that it offers fast and repeatable deployments. It offers easy scale up, scale down with the help of Nova. Ironic as well is having full, of course, with Nova having full support for multi-tenancy and with support of the Nova scheduler and placement API, we have really good data center-wide intelligent resource orchestrators, and we had really good advancement in the area of scheduler. So we can safely say that Ironic together with Nova offers best in the market intelligent resource orchestration in the data center. And of course, there is a lot of tools, processes, and software which is running on top of OpenStack API, and all this which was developed for instance VMs, VM instances, works as well for bare metal instances. And why people would like to deploy their workload directly on bare metal? So the first and the most obvious is because they would like to have no virtualization overhead. They would like to extract maximum performance out of their resources, and they would like to have lowest possible latency. And the other thing is that with virtualization, we very frequently hit the noise neighbor problem. In bare metal, this problem is shifted to a different place where you can better manage that. And a lot of hardware that is introduced recently to the market offers very low level optimizations that can be accessed only when running directly on the bare metal. So within a time, those solutions are being extended to offer full support for virtualization, but it's not necessarily happening in the very early stages. And of course, a lot of hardware is having issues with the virtualization. I don't know if any of you have known that QEMU has a limitation that VM was not able to have more than 256 cores. It was fixed recently, but before that, it was not possible. And there was a bunch of improvements in integration between OpenStack and Ironic in the last year. So to go further with the feature parity between VM instances and bare metal instances, the biggest was the networking area improvement. So right now we can safely say that they are almost equal with small differences. And there is also a lot of work that is happening right now. So in terms of rooted networks, boot from volume, and a lot of stuff needs to happen, which is extremely important for like intelligent resource orchestration in data center. I mean, mostly affinity and anti-affinity and dynamic RAID configuration, which is not yet in Nova. I mean, in Nova for bare metal use case. And for what specific use cases one can use bare metal instances? First one is virtualization, so I hope that everyone is aware about the OOO, and that's exactly the use case. So where we have under cloud, which is built with help of the Ironic, and then we have bare metal instances on which we are deploying OpenStack itself. It's called overcloud in the OOO terminology. And for running containers directly on the bare metal, as I said, so if you want to get maximum performance out of your compute resources, going for bare metal is the perfect use case. And as Kubernetes is offering their own scheduler, you can put as much applications onto the single bare metal cluster and make sure that they all work well. And with the recent advancement in the Kubernetes related to resource isolation, which is happening right now, you can also be much more secure in terms of noisy neighbor problem as well. And big data and analytics, so everyone probably knows Hadoop, Spark, so everyone knows how like CPU hungry this application is, and Hadoop and Spark really likes to live as close as possible to storage, and running directly on bare metal offers you that you can take advantage of the direct storage protocols like NVMe, which is not really possible with virtualization, and for HPC. So HPC is that kind of environment which is like seeing a lot of legacy deployments, and it's very hard to convince those scientific guys that they should migrate to the cloud because they get used to their tools, and a lot of those tools simply doesn't work on inside a VM. So with Bare Metal and Ironic, we can simply mimic their old environment with some features that clouds offers. And this is a super example of building a bridge that we can show people how to migrate from legacy to the cloud environment. And HPC is also really about multiple different hardware accelerators, and like no virtualization helps them to extract more out of those hardware resources they have in their own data centers. And historically, Bare Metal provisioning is not the really fast performing one. So when you compare the time which is needed to deploy a VM instance versus a Bare Metal instance, there is a significant difference. So VM is seconds, while Bare Metal instance is minutes. And one of the areas that we identified is simply delivering images to the Bare Metal instance, because as it works right now, it's being delivered from the centralized point. And when you deploy, let's say, 100 nodes at the same time, you're simply overloading north-south capacity. You are putting a lot of stress on your centralized storage when you store the images. And we figured out that by employing peer-to-peer network, like Torrent, we can remove a lot of stress from those components. And our experiment that we did together with Mirantis on 1 gigabit network, 1 gigabyte operating system image and 15 nodes, which were provisioned at the same time, showed that we can reduce provisioning time by half. So it's a significant advancement, and also we removed a lot of stress on different parts of the infrastructure. And the second thing is that simply booting Bare Metal instance is taking time, because usually when you provision a machine, it needs to be powered on, it needs to go over the pixie boot, it needs to load the kernel RAM disk, and then there is an Ironic Python agent which is downloading the image, writing it to the hard drive and doing the reboot. So our answer to that problem is that with the expense of additional power consumption in your data center, you can reduce the provisioning time by simply having all unused servers already loaded Ironic Python agent RAM disk. And what happens when someone is requesting to launch an instance, it's simply downloading the image, writing it to the hard drive and doing the reboot. So by this, we are cutting the instance deployment time by half. And going even further, we can remove the last reboot with kernel exec. So the kernel exec is the feature that you can replace one kernel with a different one. And in case when you're deploying Linux instances, you can take advantage of this model. And in this model, Bare Metal instance deployment time is even smaller than VM deployment time, because you simply write image to the hard drive, which is dedicated for a single machine, so there is no hard drive sharing, and you just reload the kernel and you are done. And why Intel is investing so much in Bare Metal provisioning? Because we believe that future lies in a Bare Metal resources in data center, and Intel is actively pushing development of Intel Rackscale Design Platform, which is trying to answer many problems that data center operators are reporting nowadays. So it's simply disaggregated compute, storage, and network, and whenever you would like to deploy a workload, you are not trying to fit it to existing infrastructure, but you build physical infrastructure on demand. So you select CPUs, memory, storage, compose a node, and deploy a workload. And Rackscale Design is built on top of standard Redfish API, so everyone can leverage that API in their own products. And we also having an integration between OpenStack and Intel Rackscale Design. And sorry, I ran out of time. Are there any questions? Okay, so just quickly finishing. So we did some POC of integration between OpenStack, Ironic, Nova, and Intel Rackscale Design, and simply deploying a workload on Intel Rackscale Design is as easy as launching an instance on OpenStack. You just simply select an image, you select a flavor, and then you are done. So if anyone knows how much effort it takes to put all the hardware resources into the Ironic database, with Intel Rack Scale Design, you forgot about that because you simply provide single Redfish endpoint URL, credentials, and you are done. All information about the hardware is automatically populated to Ironic, or it's actually when the node is composed, then the node in Ironic is created and being provisioned. And when if anyone is interested in hearing more about the Intel Rack Scale Design, we are having a demo booth at the marketplace where you can see this in action. Or if anyone is interested in OpenStack on Kubernetes in action, we are having that as well. So thank you very much.